हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। आई एम वैशाली केकान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द डिस्पर्शन मेजरमेंट। फर्स्ट वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द डिस्पर्शन, व्हाट इज इट्स इफेक्ट ऑन द नेटवर्क, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इट्स डिफरेंट टाइप्स एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू वेरियस मेथड्स बाय विच वी कैन मेजर डिस्पर्शन। So first of all, what is the dispersion? Dispersion is the effect of pulse broadening. So if I have the input pulse like this, and when it was propagated through the optical fiber, the output pulse was like this. So this is a pulse broadening that has happened. The width of the pulse has increased, and I can say the pulse has broadened out, and due to which we have the limitation on the speed of the device. We cannot do the fast communication if I have the higher dispersion inside the fiber. So this is the reason the measurement of the dispersion becomes of significant interest. It is going to limit the channel capacity as well. So now I hope you understood the significance of the dispersion. Now coming to the different types of dispersion. First we have the intermodal dispersion. As the name suggests, it is a dispersion in between the different modes. We know we have the different modes at the different frequencies, and if I have the different modes, they are propagating inside the fiber with different velocity. So when these are propagating with the different velocity, at the end, at the receiver, they are going to cause the effect of pulse broadening, that is a dispersion. So I hope you understood what is intermodal dispersion. Then we have the chromatic dispersion. The chromatic dispersion is present only in the one mode, and it is present due to the group delay. Right, so why we have the chromatic dispersion? When we have the different elements of the different wavelength, right, but we have the same mode. So different elements of the different wavelength are going to travel with the different speed inside the optical fiber, and at the end they are going to do the pulse broadening. Now coming to the PMD, right? PMD is the polarization mode dispersion. So we know the effect of the polarization. The polarization, we have the various polarized signal. The signal can be having a vertical polarized signal and a horizontal polarized signal. So we know both of the signals are traveling with a different speed. So these two signals, if they are traveling with a different speed inside the optical fiber, they are going to do the pulse broadening, right? So PMD is going to tell me the splitting of the light into the orthogonal components. These are the orthogonal components. One component is vertical, another is horizontal. So splitting of light in these two components is done by the polarization, and we can have the dispersion due to the different speed of these orthogonal component, which is PMD. Right, so I hope you understood all four types of dispersion. So we are going to talk about the measurements now. So first is time domain intermodal dispersion measurement. So this is the intermodal dispersion. So we have to see how in the time domain we can measure the dispersion, which is intermodal. Right, so first of all, we will be taking the electrical pulse. We will be having any input signal. Let's suppose this is my input signal, right? So if I take this input signal, I will be sending it to the optical link and the electrical link. So this is the optical link. In the optical link, we will be having the laser. So I will be sending this signal to the laser and this signal to the variable delay as well. So now this signal, when sent to the laser, this signal is going to produce the light. So laser is going to produce the light in accordance to this signal. So light will be having intensity in accordance to this signal. Then we have the mode scrambler. Mode scrambler is going to scramble out or intermix the different modes, right? So here I will be having the different modes, and this is my fiber under test, right? So after the mode scrambler, after choosing any mode, the input light is sent to the fiber. Now this fiber under test is connected to the optical input of optical sampling oscilloscope. So optical sampling oscilloscope will be having two input, optical input and electrical input. The fiber under test is connected to the optical input. Now after the variable delay, this is the electrical signal only. We are sending the electrical signal also to the optical sampling oscilloscope. In the fiber under test, if I send the different modes, I will be having the intermodal dispersion. So the optical sampling oscilloscope will get the electrical signal and the optical signal, and now it is going to compare both of them. So different mode will be having different velocity and is going to cause the light broadening inside this fiber under test. Right, so optical sample oscilloscope is comparing these two signals, and this is how we will be getting the output signal on the display of the OSO. On the display of OSO, we will be seeing this signal, which is the electrical signal, which was the perfect signal that we had sent. But this is the optical signal, which has broadened out. Right, so if I see this signal will be seen as it is in the electrical signal. But if I see the optical signal would have broadened out due to the intermodal dispersion. Right, so now here the dispersion depends upon the number of modes. How many number of modes the scrambler had said inside the fiber under test. Right, so this is how we can measure the dispersion. For different combination of modes, I can find out the maximum dispersion that the fiber under test is going to have. Right, so now coming to the polarization mode dispersion measurement. How we are going to measure the polarization mode dispersion? We now know what is the PMD, right? So now here we will be taking a broadband optical source. The broadband optical source will be having both vertical component and the horizontal component. Let's suppose the vertical component is my desired component and the horizontal component is my undesired component, right? So if I want to extract the output, I will extract it from the vertical component only. The horizontal component and the vertical component will be having different speed when they are supplied to the fiber under test, and they will be providing the PMD losses, right? So now what I will be doing, I will be taking only the vertical signal. The vertical signal is my desired signal. So I will be choosing a polarizer which is going to send only the vertical signal. Polarizer is choosing only the vertical signal. It is rejecting the horizontal signal. So here at the input of the polarizer, I had both vertical and the horizontal signal. But when I send this signal to the polarizer, I will be having only the vertical signal. Now this vertical signal is sent to the fiber under test. Now in the fiber under test, I will be having some dispersion due to the polarization. I will be having some horizontal component also. So this horizontal component is again sent to the polarizer, which is going to detect only the horizontal component. Now this horizontal component was not there at the input of the fiber under test, but it came after I propagated the signal under the fiber under test. So this is the undesired signal that came from the fiber under test only. So we have to measure this horizontal component, which is going to tell me what is the amount of PMD. So we can do it with the help of optical spectrum analyzer. So with the help of optical spectrum analyzer, I can measure what amount of horizontal component I have, right? So now coming to the frequency domain intermodal dispersion. This thing I have done in the time domain. Now coming to the frequency domain. In the frequency domain, again, we have the electrical pulse, we have the optical and the electrical link. In the optical link, again, I am sending the signal to the laser, then to the mode scrambler, then to the fiber under test, and then I am connecting it to the optical input of the spectrum analyzer. The electrical pulse I am sending to the variable delay, and then I am sending it to the spectrum analyzer, right? So spectrum analyzer is going to show me what is the broadening in the frequency domain. So it's the same thing that we have discussed in the time domain, but here we have used the optical sampling oscilloscope. Here we will be using the spectrum analyzer, right? So now coming to the chromatic dispersion measurement. Here we have to understand that it is occurring due to only one mode due to the group velocity. So here we will be taking a tunable narrow band optical source so that it will not be containing a lot of frequency components. It will be containing a very narrow frequency band, right? So it will be having only one frequency components. Let's assume it. We are sending it to the optical coupler. So after the optical coupler, we are sending it to the intensity modulator, which is changing the intensity of this signal. And after that, I will be sending it to the fiber under test. So after the fiber under test, this light signal is sent to the photoreceiver, and the photoreceiver is now going to detect this optical signal and it is going to convert it into the electrical form, right? Here at the intensity modulator, I am going to send the electrical signal, and this is the electrical signal. The electrical signal is then transmitted to the comparator. So now here directly I can use the photo detector. After the intensity modulator, I have not used any fiber. Here I have used the fiber, but here without any fiber I can do the conversion from the light to the electrical signal with the help of photo detector. Right, so photo detector is going to convert this light signal into the electrical signal, and the phase comparator is going to check what is the difference between the phase in between the two signals, and this is how we can compare the group velocity. So this is how you can see we have the relative group delay, which is the output which is coming on the phase comparator, and this is how with respect to the relative group delay we can calculate the dispersion. So I hope you understood all of the four methods of measuring the dispersion and what are the dispersion, what are these different types. I hope if you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I will be trying to resolve your doubt as soon as possible. If you like this video, you are going to push the like button, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, and also give me your feedback. Thank you so much.